Okay, last week we talked about the birth of Samuel, how his mama had asked for him specifically, and God gave him as a gift, and then she gave him as a gift back to God. She took him to the tabernacle, gave him to Eli the priest to serve God for his whole life. God went ahead and blessed Hannah with at least 5 more children. And evidently her rival grew old prematurely and sick and weakly. God blessed Hannah because of her gift to him and her faithfulness. Well, as Samuel grew up, he would take care of things around the sanctuary, the tabernacle. I keep wanting to say temple, but the temple hasn't been built yet. So if I say temple, I mean tabernacle. He took care of things around the tabernacle and helped Eli wherever he could. Eli at this point is an old man, and he is almost completely blind. And he did have sons who worked as priests, but they were, to say they weren't very good is an understatement. They actively stole from the people who came to offer sacrifices, and they had affairs with the women who came, and they just were nice people. They were not serving God. And God sent a prophet to Eli and said, look, you'd better get your sons under control or else. But Eli didn't do anything. He didn't rein them in. He didn't make them behave themselves. He didn't replace them, which is what he should have done. At one point, Samuel was lying in bed one night, and the Bible says he slept near the Ark of the Covenant, that big box that Moses made that had the manna and Aaron's rod and all of that. So he was laying there in bed, fixing to go to sleep, and he heard, Samuel, Samuel. So he jumped up, and he ran into Eli, and he said, I'm here, what do you need? And Eli said, I didn't call you, go back to bed. So Samuel went back to bed, and after things were quiet again, he heard, Samuel, Samuel. And he jumped up, and he went back to Eli, and Eli said, I did not call you, go back to bed. You're imagining things. Again, he heard, Samuel, Samuel. So he went in to Eli, and he said, I'm here, you called me. And Eli said, I know what's happening. Next time you hear that calling, you say, speak, Lord, I'm listening. Because Eli figured out that it was God speaking to Samuel. So Samuel went back to bed. Things got quiet. And again he heard, Samuel, Samuel. So he said, speak, Lord, I'm listening. And God told him, I'm fixing to change Israel. Eli's sons are not good people, and I'm going to remove them. And everything's going to be different. It was really rare at this time. There have been times in history when God did not speak very often to people. He seemed to have gone quiet for certain periods of time. And this was one of those periods of time, so people weren't used to listening for God. In the morning, Eli said, hey, Samuel, what'd God tell you? And if you don't tell me everything he said, then I pray that God punish you severely. So Samuel told him, he said your sons are bad, and he's going to kill them, and things are going to change. And Eli said, okay, that's exactly what the prophet told me a while ago, so God's good. He'll take care of whatever needs taken care of. From this time on, Samuel did hear from God. God spoke to him frequently. And people began to realize that what Samuel said happened. And Samuel became a strong, wise leader in Israel. He was the last prophet to be the head leader of Israel. And he plays a very important role in the history of Israel. So we will learn more about Samuel later. Let's sing our song.
One door and only one, and yet the sides are two. Inside and outside, on which side are you? One door and only one, and yet the sides are two. One heart and only one, and yet